Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you all are well. So today we are going to talk about the G20 summit that took place in Rome, Italy. And it was held on 30th and 31st of October 2021. The world had expectations from G20 nations, especially regarding the climate change and the global warming. And the world had expected some major decision making on the G20 summit platform. Now let's briefly talk about that. What is G20? G20, as the name suggests, is a group of 20. It is actually a group of 19 countries and the European Union. Here, European Union itself is a group of 27 countries. Earlier, before Brexit, there were 28 countries, and now there are 27 countries in the European Union, and UK is now separately a part of G20. So if we talk about G20, then it is an international intergovernmental forum or platform, or you can say it is an organization that aims to address issues concerning global economy, because it comprises of the world's 20 largest economies. Moreover, G20 works to address the concerns regarding international financial stability and climate change mitigation, as well as sustainable development goals. G20 is considered to be a very strong platform because the group accounts for approximately 80% of the global GDP, around 75% of international trade, and 60% of the world's population, and roughly half of the world's land area. And that's huge, which is why it is considered a very important and a strong platform for any decision making. This G20 was founded in 1999, especially in response to the several world economic crises. But since 2008, the group convenes at least once a year with summits involving each member's head of government or the head of state. It is summit. Summit means that it is the peak of a mountain. Summit jo hai hum peak of the mountain ko kehte hain, means the highest official. To kisi bhi state ka jo highest official hota hai, that is the head of state or the head of government. So basically the G20 summit is convened once a year, which is attended by the head of the state or the head of government of the member states. So recently this G20 summit was held in Rome, Italy, and it continued for 2 days, that is 30th and 31st of October 2021, and it was hosted by the Italian Prime Minister Mario Draghi. This G20 summit was actually the 16th summit, and last year it was held in Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, and next year it is expected to be held in Bali, Indonesia. So this year, the final summit document was called as the G20 Rome Leaders Declaration. And to talk about the recent G20 summit agenda this year, the G20 nations addressed most pressing global challenges and pledged to make concerted efforts to recover from the COVID-19 crisis and enable sustainable and inclusive growth across the world. Moreover, the G20 nations committed to overcoming the global health and economic crisis stemming from the pandemic, and that has already resulted in significantly reduced progress towards achievement of these sustainable development goals. Also, they discussed the various COVID variants and the uneven vaccine distribution. So the idea is that they discussed health in general, and they committed to make and advance their efforts to ensure 40% of global goals of vaccination by the end of 2021 and 70% of world population being vaccinated by mid-2022. So the point is that this year the G20 summit's agenda was focused around some pressing global issues and challenges. For example, the COVID-19 crisis and the delay in achieving sustainable development goals, and also the need to attain sustainable growth across the world, and to keeping in view the situation all around the world, the G20 nations, being the world's largest economies, they committed and pledged to overcome the global health and economic crisis. Because ये economic crisis or health crisis ही है जिसकी वजह से there is significant delay in the progress towards the achievement of the sustainable development goals. And to avoid this, they discussed the various COVID variants and also they highlighted the issue of the uneven vaccine distribution. This is the major concern nowadays. So generally they discussed health in general, and they committed, और उन्होंने ये commit किया कि they will seek to make efforts and they will advance their efforts to ensure कि जो 40% global population है वो vaccinated हो जानी चाहिए by the end of 2021. And they also pledged के 2022 के mid तक they seek to achieve this goal के तब तक 70% जो global population है that should be vaccinated by mid 2022. Moreover, they generally discussed the achievement of the sustainable development goals, and they discussed the climate change, and the G20 nations welcomed the UN declaration of the decade, that is 2021 to 2030, as the UN decade on ecosystem restoration. यहाँ पर ये बात आपको याद होनी चाहिए कि जो UN है, UN has declared this decade from 2021 to 2020 as the UN decade on ecosystem restoration. This is very important for MCQs, so do note it down. इसके अलावा हम अगर स्पेसिफिकली क्लाइमेट चेंज की बात करें तो G20 नेशन से एक्सपेक्ट किया जा रहा था कि दे विल हैव सम सीरियस कॉन्वर्जेशन रिगार्डिंग द क्लाइमेट चेंज, द क्लाइमेट क्राइसिस एंड द ग्लोबल, एंड दे विल डिस्कस द ग्लोबल वार्मिंग एंड दे विल मेक सम सीरियस डिसीजंस रिगार्डिंग दिस वेरी सीरियस इशू, बट दिस वॉज नॉट सीन. As it is evident that the G20 summit ended without any time-bound promise on climate change, because the G20 nations only discussed the relevance of achieving global net zero on carbon emissions by or around mid-century. Matlab ke they said ke they acknowledged ke there is need and there is relevance of achieving global net zero on carbon emissions by or around mid-century. They did not give even a deadline for the global net zero emissions of carbon, which was deemed as a very non-serious attitude of the G20 nations. But still, Italian Prime Minister Mario Draghi hailed the G20 summit as success, saying that for the first time, all G20 states had agreed on the importance of capping global warming at 1.5 degrees Celsius. Now, here it is pertinent to mention that this temperature 1.5 degrees Celsius is the threshold that what UN experts say must be met to avoid a dramatic acceleration of extreme climate events like droughts, storms and floods, and to reach it they recommend net zero emissions should be achieved by 2050. So the idea is ke G20 summit se ye kafi expectations lagayi gayi thi ke they will be discussing the climate change issue and consider it as a major global issue, and there will be decision making regarding this issue, but that was not seen, and still the Italian Prime Minister said that it is a G20 is a success because this was the first time that all G20 states had agreed on the importance of capping global warming at 1.5 degrees Celsius. मतलब कि इन अ सेंस कि जो तमाम G20 नेशंस हैं वो इस बात को मानती हैं कि देर इज़ नीड कि जो है जो टेम्परेचर थ्रेशोल्ड है उसको अचीव किया जाए, दैट इज़ 1.5 डिग्री सेल्सियस, जो कि यूएन एक्सपर्ट्स की तरफ से ये एक 1.5 डिग्री थ्रेशोल्ड बनाया गया है, दैट दे से दैट इट इज़ टू बी मेट टू अवॉइड अ ड्रामेटिक एक्सेलरेशन ऑफ एक्सट्रीम क्लाइमेट इवेंट्स, जैसा कि वी सी फ्रीक्वेंट ड्राउट्स, स्टॉर्म्स एंड फ्लड्स. So to avoid this, there is need to achieve this 1.5 degree Celsius threshold. and obviously to reach it, they recommend net zero emissions should be there achieved by 2050. So the world leaders seemed quite optimistic regarding climate change discussions, but analysts believe that G20 offered little new on climate and leaving uphill task for Conference of Parties 26, that is 26th United Nations Climate Change Conference of the Parties, and that is to be held in Scotland. And now if we talk about the criticisms on this G20 summit, so it was said that it was said by the Frederick Roder, that is the Vice President of Sustainable Development Advocacy Group Global Citizen. He said that this was a moment for the G20 to act with the responsibility they have as the biggest emitters. Yet we only see half measures rather than concrete urgent action. This he said while criticizing the G20 leaders. G20 are considered the biggest emitters of carbon because these nations account for 80% of the world's primary energy use. And that is the report published by the Institute for International Political Studies. According to their report, the G20 nations are the biggest emitters and account for 80% of the world's primary energy use. And most importantly, if we talk about the UN Secretary General, then UN Secretary General said G20 summit did not meet his climate hopes. So as referring to climate change agreements reached at the G20 summit, UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres tweeted, "I leave Rome with my hopes unfulfilled, but at last they are not buried." So this was the disappointment he shared. So this was all brief and important highlights about the recent G20 summit. We'll discuss another topic in our next video. For now, that's all. Thank you so much. Take care. Bye-bye.